So recording started. So now you see we are going to our main place, this one. Now what we are talking about? We are talking about this one, that is Web Analyzer. Web, A-N-A-L-Y-S-E-R. So this is the Web Analyzer. So these are, so you can have the different types of Web Analyzer softwares are available. One Web Analyzer, so if you use Chrome, you will get that one, the Web Analyzer. The Chrome extension is also available. But if you want to get that one, say that is just Web Analyzer, now click it and you will see that on the first you are getting webanalyzer.io. This is a simple but powerful website performance monitoring tool that helps you to understand poor performing indicators. So this is what, just click it. And here you see, this is rather the Web Analyzer tool. So now, what you see this one, this Web Analyzer tool is, so this is the daily quota because you are using the free version. So on free trial, 7 days left. So you can do that one in the trial mode also, or others are also there. I will show you that one. So in this place, you have to enter the address of one website. Specifically, you can write here the address of library websites. So that will be given to you, or rather I will tell you that one, what to what address are to be typed. So here you just have to type the address of the website. Now see, check it, this one, NATIONAL, National Digital Library of India. Now this is what the National Digital Library of India, the you can get virtually all material here. So digital material, whatever the material is rather digitized, it is available in this repository, and it is being run by the IIT Kharagpur and the Computer Science Department and IIT Kharagpur Central Library. So now see, this is the address, just copy it. And see, the site is looking very colorful. Here the color is there, here, and here you see one animation and lot of things are there, NDLI club, language. So suppose you want to analyze this site. So copy it, close it, and here type this one, the address of that particular site, and click start test. Now you will see that one, it is rather searching the website, and then it will give you the result after the analysis is complete. And performance is, this is poor. If this is red, that is poor. If this is, I think this is what, so some kind of color like yellow, average, and this is good, brown, sorry, green. So check it, see, it's still going, okay, it's ongoing, so you, okay. Okay, now you see the result, I didn't get it. The result, no websites, but you did it, but I do not know what happened. So user dashboard, okay, this monitoring, okay, this one. Now see, server response. See there. So this is the standard, good, average, poor. This is the page size. This is a total page. HTTP enable not, page load time. And what is good parameter, what is bad parameter, it is given there. It is also searching. And now just you go to the, and here you will see that one. What are the differences? Yes. Now you are getting the result. Mind it, all green are good, all yellows are average, okay. We got that one. See, you only have to include these grades. These grades. Now see, you got that one score. What is the score of this one? So out of 100, this one got 65, which is rather a poor performance. Server response is this, it is bad. Page size is good. Total request is this. This is not HTTP enabled. So what all these things mean, I will tell you later. But you can do this one by this way. So two software I am telling you. This is the online one. You haven't to download anything. You just only have to have the internet connectivity. And here also you will see that one. The grade is given here. This is a suggestion. So your task is just to get this performance grade and at the same time these results. Okay. Now I am showing you a second one, that is another webalizer that is known as web analyzer, Nibbler, and that is also, you see, something like that previous one, web analyzer. Now here you type again that this HTTP is not required, this one, and click this. Now here you see the report. In Nibbler, It is giving it the result as 7.3 and experience accessibility 8.7, 7.6, marketing is rather bad and technology is this. And you can see what are the different tests it did. These are the tests that were done. Okay. Improvement measures are given. So analytics is not done because you have to popularity. This is the 19,895th popular website in the world. Okay, ranking. This is the ranking. So this is the this one most popular website in the world. So that is before it, there are 19,894 websites are there. Okay. Freshness is 4.2, last updated November 30, 2020. In 2021, no update is there. And these are the different headings. And this is known as, you see, the tag cloud. So it is having the tag cloud videos. So you can go by this way. And if you want, you can download this one also. Or download means you have to print that one from this place. So you can print that one from this place, and by this way you can keep this one for your record. So only thing is that what you have to do in your fine in your first semester, how many such thing you did in your first semester, how many titles you did? For digital
reference tool, minimum 15, sir.
You did 15?
Yes, sir. 19.
30, most probably, no?
Yes, sir.
There is 10 category.
In the question, there is 30, but I said 19.
But according to
15 only, sir. Or will told us.
Okay. So this time, you just have to analyze 10 sites. Okay. 10 sites only. 10 sites and analysis of each site will carry 5 marks. So 5 into 10, that will be 50. 50 marks for that one. Now, what are the sites, or rather what the sites you want, or you will have to do that one? So I am telling you, you better take 5 national sites and 5 international sites. 5 national websites, 5 international websites, which are specifically for library and information science domain. Just on the basis on library and information science. As for example, we have got that one that is the National Digital Library. You can go for searching that one, that is library and information science sites in India, library and information sites in world. So from that one, you can take 5 from India, or 5 Indian sites and 5 foreign sites, international sites, and evaluate that one with the help of Weblizer or Nibbler. Any one you can use, I'm not forcing you. So as because both are rather being used by so many people, so you can use Nibbler. Nibbler is, so each and every software is having its own algorithm, so you cannot compare Nibbler with a Web Analyzer. In Web Analyzer, the report you will get, this is something which is coming. So my judgment will be, that is how far you are being able to use the digital tools for accessing that one, or for accessing the value, or the accessing the content of that particular site, not actually what the result that is coming out. So this is what you have to do. So what you can do, you can, after analysis, you can make a PDF file, or rather you can print that one from this site itself, or rather from the Chrome itself, and save that one with the name of the site, or rather just by the name of the site, or by rather name your roll number, then one, then so just like that one, your roll number one, roll number, your roll number, then two, your roll number, then three, PDF. So make 10 such thing and you can upload that one via the interface I will develop in our departmental website. So this is for paper 208. So this is not the end of discussion of 208. So I will come for this one again. I will discuss this thing again. So but whenever you will be getting some bit of free time, you can exercise some practice, or you can do some practice by taking some of the sites, so general sites like dlisnbu.ac.in, or rather my site, or rather some other sites, just to see that one. That is what are the results that are coming. Then you can ask me the queries, you can ask me the issues. That is, I am not understanding that thing, I am not understanding. So parameters, what you have to include in your report, I will discuss that one. I will give you the exact parameters, what are to be included in your report. Some of the parameters you can drop. So what are the parameters that we need to be dropped? So that will also be discussed later. Okay. So this is what your initial, or rather the ignitional class, the very, 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 very first instruction regarding paper 208. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Three bags full, you know?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. Disha understands that one too.
Sir, sir, do we have to directly print the PDF and have to send to the NBU, or we have to make our own PDF file?
You have to make your own PDF file. See how? Okay, then let me show you again. So, as for example, you see, suppose. So see, NIBLLER, Nibbler, and this is Nibbler, and you are testing, suppose, DLISNBU site, https://dlisnbu.ac.in. Suppose you are testing this one. Go for it. Check it. Now see, this is the report. Report for DLISNBU, overall 7.3, accessibility 9.7, okay? So this one, mobile page link, this one, experience 7.0, marketing, so we do not market. Technology is also very good. See the meta tags, I didn't give meta tags, so I'm getting this one. Images, printability, internet link, server behavior, mobile. So, and at the same time, they have given us for some priorities for improvement of this one, and Twitter is not related with it because our department has no official Twitter account, so I didn't go for that one. So, and Twitter account, they are asking us. Then analytics, they didn't do that one. Popularity, this is not yet been ranked because the departmental site, meta tag, incoming link. So now see, 100% image, you have the clearly defined site, okay? 16 images are defined. So this is the content. Now what you have to do, as because you are using the free version, not the pro version, they won't allow you to get the finer PDF file generation. Pro version will only give you the real PDF generation. So your task is only to go to this place and click a print button, and you see Microsoft print to PDF is there, at the same time save as PDF is there. And this is what, if you see this one, it will come like this. So you cannot do anything more better for this one. Okay. So now you save it, and while you are saving this one, you have to save that one with your roll number. Like suppose you have your roll number 1978325. So this is roll number, and this is one. One means what? This is the first one. You have to make 10. So this is 1.pdf. So save it. So done. Close it. Minimize it. And here you see, that is this one. This one is yours. So click it and you will see this one, that is this. And here you will get that one, that is the overall summary technology, this one. Just only this thing. Okay. So, oh my God. Okay. So you got that one. So only thing is that, now see the size of this one. The size of this one is properties. See, this is 883 KB. So just like that one, you will have other 9. So total, you just make all these things and make a archive file, GIF file, and then upload that one in the departmental site so that I can access that one from that particular place. Clear enough?
We have to merge all the PDF together and send in to the website.
So first make 10 PDF for 10 such files. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then make a GIF it in a single file and give your roll number. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Roll number along with the paper, that is your roll number underscore BLCC208, and upload it. No issues. Hilar?
Yes, sir.
Sir, we have to convert 10 PDF into one WinZip file. And then we have to upload just one zip file in the department website.
Yes. Because if you, no, not one PDF, you can make that one GIF file. It's okay. Make 10 PDF files for 10 sites, and then make a GIF file, archive file, and just upload the archive file.
So if we one PDF for all of them, then it will okay, na sir?
Kya hai?
Main agar ek hi PDF 10 ko merge karke banata hu to hoga na sir?
10 ko merge karke banaoge, acha theek hai, chalo dekho 10 ko merge karoge to size bada ho jayega. PDF merge karne se PDF ka size bahut bada ho jata hai. अभी एक एक का साइज आया, अभी 1 MB का नीचे वो 884 KB, 10 का मानो तो 9 MB होगा मैक्सिमम, उसको जीप करोगे तो 4 MB पे आ जाएगा, और तुम पीडीएफ को मार्च करोगे तो 25 MB आ जाएगा
जी.
तो अभी अभी खुद समझ लो क्या करोगे
जी सर.
ओके, थैंक यू. और कोई किसी का कोई प्रॉब्लम है ये पेपर लेके, ये जो काम मैंने बताया?
Sir, as you told, 10 questions are there. Sir, will the link is also provided in the question paper? As you mentioned, the international link or national links.
See, for this paper, for this particular paper, there won't be any question paper at all. Okay. This is the internal, this is one paper which will be evaluated internally, and that's why what you really desire, you just do that one. Only instruction is that you have to take 5 web address from Indian web address and 5 web address from international, but all the websites must be on library and information science. Other than that, that will be considered. So even you can start that way right now also. And only thing, wait for the place, wait for the, whenever the, your notification for examination will be there, I will make one place by which you can upload that one in our site.
So this time also we'll be having our exam online only?
Obviously. See, dekho, abhi kya bataya, tum logo ka exam ka time kab hai?
Sir, last week of the August or first week of the September?
No. July 9th to 18th, 7th July to 9th July. In website there is a...
দেখ তাহলে কি কি সঞ্জয় এগুলো কি কথাবার্তা বলো, একটু সেপ্টেম্বরে নিয়ে গেছে, হায় হায় রে।
আচ্ছা স্যার নোটিশ কবে পাবলিশ হলো?
তা আমি কেমন করে, আমি তো তোদের রুটিন দিয়ে দিই, তোদের তো ইয়ে দিয়ে দিয়েছি, একাডেমিক ক্যালেন্ডার দিয়েছি।
হ্যাঁ আছে স্যার, অগস্ট মাসে কিছু দিয়ে
গেল না,
একাডেমিক ক্যালেন্ডার দেখ, ওই ক্যালেন্ডারই বলে দেওয়া আছে কখন পরীক্ষা হবে। জুনের 15 তারিখে খুলবে মানে গভর্নমেন্ট যেটা বলেছে আর কি, দোয়ার দা গভর্নমেন্ট স্টেটেড অলরেডি, সো মোস্ট প্রোবাবলি এভরিথিং উইল রিওপেন ইন 15th অফ জুন. So after 16th of June, but the month of June is rather the recess period for the students as well as for the faculties. Okay, June month hocche chuti thake university. Jodio ami jabo, so I have to go because I am the head of the department, so I have to go that one. But your exam form fill up and everything, I think this will commence from the 1st of July or like that. So they will issue notification because that is before 15th. Don't expect any such thing. Eibare porikha.
Actually, I'll be having master's exam also in July and BLIS exams also in July, sir. So that's why I was asking.
So you have to drop one thing. So no one can help you in this case because already the academic schedule is prepared by the faculty council. And if you are doing two courses simultaneously and without informing any of the department, so are you a student of distance education? Rajshree?
Yes, sir.
Are you a student of distance education?
Sir, yes, sir. I'm doing master's in English from IGNO, so.
IGNO, which university?
IGNO, sir.
IGNO. Okay. No problem. For distance education, we are not having any such botheration. We do not even give any such kind of restrictions for the distance education students. But only thing is that if there is an overlap with your papers, then I do not know what we can do. But if you really have that one, so already... Did you get your schedule? That is, at what time your examination will happen?
Sir, from IGNO?
Yes, the dates?
Sir, dates are not mentioned, but the timing is from 9 to 12.
9 to 12, and ours will be 12 yes, to 3. Okay, in IGNO, are you good on, is it on the online mode?
No, sir. I guess this time we will have to appear the examination itself.
Physical appearance?
Yes, sir. Because like in first semester, we were allowed marks through our assignments only. So, but now I guess we have to give our examination physically.
Okay, very good. So now see, in our cases, so this is your case, fine, it's okay. But for all students of NBU, I'm telling you, till date, there is no such decision whether the examination will be held physically or not. Okay. Or that the student has to be present, or students have to be present in the university physically. because you see the third wave is second wave rather, that second wave and post second wave is still going on, and I do not think that university will take that risk of asking you, inviting you to the university for examination. If that will happen, that
yes,
will be, if that will happen, that will be a fine thing. But I do not think that one, because whatever the communication I already had with the authority, I assume that one, that is the examination will be in the online mode. Okay. So I'm very sorry for you, because none of you will be able to see the department in such a way. But as because you are saying that one, your examination will be in from July. Let's see after June what instruction comes from the authority. Okay. So this is what.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Sir, by the way, sir, what's the status of our result of first semester?
देखो ये जो चीज तुम पूछ रहे हो ना ये
yes,
जो
sir.
ये जो चीज तुम पूछ रहे हो ये चीज अब कंसीडरेशन का बाहर है क्यों क्योंकि दिस इज द गवर्नमेंट ऑर्डर बाय व्हिच ऑल द एकेडमिक इंस्टीट्यूशंस एंड अदर इंस्टीट्यूशंस आर रादर क्लोज्ड 15 डेज पास्ड हो गया अभी मोर 13 डेज और 14 डेज है कोई आदमी नहीं जा रहा है यूनिवर्सिटी में कोई आदमी काम ही नहीं कर रहा है ओके नो वन इज डूइंग एनीथिंग सो मोस्ट प्रोबेबली योर रिजल्ट एवरीथिंग व्हाट वी सबमिटेड दैट आर जस्ट lying on that way so only after 15th the speed will there will be some kind of expedition of other expedite they will expedite the process and you will get some result so I assume by 20th of this month we will be able to give you your result so if government doesn't extend this one more otherwise I cannot say ठीक है चार तीन पांच दिन मुझे दे दो इसे खुलने के बाद रिजल्ट निकल देंगे रिजल्ट का सभी दे दिया वहां पे हम लोग इसके आगे लेकिन ये कोरोना ये तुम लोगों का पेटी ऐसे ही है ये कोरोना तुम लोगों का इतना कुछ ट्रबल लाया जिसमें रिजल्ट भी एक है अभी मानो कि हर कोशिश के बावजूद ये हम लोग नहीं कर पा रहे हैं कि अभी क्या करें हम लोग का यूनिवर्सिटी में अभी मोर देन 15 आर रेदर इन्फेक्टेड ओके सो बंद हो गया यूनिवर्सिटी पूरा के पूरा तो ठीक है चलो अभी नेक्स्ट अच्छा नाउ व्हाट वी टॉक्ड अबाउट दैट इज what shall do that is yes
trends in cataloging
e meta shakti chamatkar ekbar sob mone rakhi chalo trends in cataloging Now let's, there is no need to run this one, but still. Just in trends in cataloging and slideshow, individual. And then from beginning, let me show you. So, in trends on cataloging, trends in cataloging, we have to deal with some of the things like the issues like this one. These are the burning issues regarding catalog. And you know that one, because of this ICT, you know the full form of ICT?
No, sir.
Do you know the full form of ICT? No?
No, sir. No, sir.
So the full form of ICT is Information and Communication Technology. Or rather, you can say, is the use of networking, internet, and the communication technology, the ICT. So, and obviously the use of computer. These prove that one, that is many of the traditional activities we usually did in past for information access. And for information access and the different tools we use for information access, information retrieval, has rather been challenged by the advent of this ICT, information technology. And one individual named as Maurice B. Lyne, M-B-L-I-N-E, Maurice B. Lyne, he talked about that one. That is, day by the day, the society is going to be one paperless society. Paperless society, and obviously we are also seeing that one. That is, each and every time the printed document, usage of printed document is rather being lesser. Everyone is giving more emphasis to the digital document or born digital document. People are not using those things like books in that way. So there is always a kind of a trust for the digital documents. And that's why the first line that is considered the opinion came from different corners of the world, that catalog is nothing but a white elephant. That is, maintaining the catalog in a library is just like purchasing one white elephant in your home. That is what? A kind of wastage of money. And no one is bothering about catalog, because right now, because of the computer, you can search your document with any tag, with any keyword. Even you can search that one by the name of the publisher, by the place, by anything. So catalog is considered as white elephant. So they stated that one, catalog is white elephant. So now we'll deal with all these things, the online trends or recent trends. So this is white elephant means the manual cataloging. So in every library, there must be a cataloger. Cataloger must know the rules of ACR2 or colon classification. They must know how to make the catalog card. They try to get what is the title, all the 8 areas of catalog. So a group of people who are in favor of this ICT and all other things, they are saying that one, in a library, using the catalog is nothing but a white elephant, specifically for the small libraries, like school libraries, like rural libraries. These are even for the bigger libraries like universities and research institutions also, catalog is rather one white elephant. This means nothing but the wastage of money. These are the issues, the first issue. Second one, cataloging is a no-brainer activity. Now, do you believe this one? Now, let me ask you. So, take your opinion also, so that we can deal with this one properly. Do you really think that cataloging is a no-brainer activity? Now, no-brainer activity means what? No-brainer activity means in classification, you have to use your brain, you have to identify the subject, place of the subject, in under the universe of subject. Okay, universe of subject, then you have to identify the associated elements, how to add that one, when there is a problem, then how you can resolve that issue. So almost all the times you have to use your mind, you have to use your brain. But in cataloging, as because the code is there and code says you everything, that is right title here, then give a dot, space, then write author name, then write edition and all other things. So this is cataloging is just a kind of clerical job, is a no-brainer activity. This is the second thing. Third thing, that is the cataloging is redundant. Like white elephant, some people are saying that on cataloging is redundant. There is no such necessity to do cataloging right now, as because no one bothers about cataloging. As for example, you see, in web, whenever people are searching any information, they usually don't bother about catalog at all. So they just go to the search box, they type their word, and they get their result. So there is no such cataloging in web, but people are getting their resources. So that is what it is redundant. Cataloging, or so not cataloging, that is catalog, specifically this should be the catalog, GUE, is obsolete. Right now, catalog is no longer required, obsolete. Cataloging can better be done with machine. If you have a machine, if you have the computer, as well as the library management software, so you can, if you have the library management software, then you can better do the cataloging with the machine. Users are not at all ready to use catalogs. So very few fellows are going to the card cabinet or printed catalog, and they do this one from there. And another thing is, people are saying that one, ACR2, Anglo-American cataloging rules, which was considered as a time guide for making the catalogs, already died. So we are not getting any version of ACR2 anymore, but we got that one. Another thing, that is the RDA, which is the future. This is the recent trend, and our trend starts from this place. This is what? The cataloging, this is the RDA. Is it the future? And what is the full form of RDA? That is RESOURCE. Resource description and ACCEWS, access. And this is what is known as RDA. Okay, so future, people are talking about resource description and access. This is the future. Right now, all these things are already dead. Okay, so now, see, this is rather a controversial issue, and some people are in favor of catalog and some people are not favoring catalog at all. Now, trends in cataloging, whenever we are talking about trends in cataloging, a trend and you see, once upon a time we had the ALA code. Manual. Then we had one. Now we got Asia 2. Okay, so actually the trend started from 1978. That is what, because you see, in cataloging, almost all the codes in cataloging bearing this CCC, classified catalog code, our Ranganathan's code, Ranganathan's code, this was totally manual. Okay. Manual. So we are getting that one, Ranganathan's code, a manual one. But in ACR 2, we got that one. Two. This is the ACR version 1. And see, after 10, 11 years, ACR 2 restructured it based on the computer feeding of information. That is, they no longer stated that one right now ACR 2 is, the code is only for manual cataloging. This can be used for the, which one? That is what? The computer-based cataloging also. Now, where is the catch? Now, computer-based cataloging, whenever you are doing anything, rather computer-based catalog, you have to make something special because computers are not as smart as you. Computers are rather not smart like you. So computers are rather some kind of dumb tools. They do this one, whatever is being fed to them. So they only reproduce that one with your inputs. So ACR2 first started this one. And in ACR2, I think all of you, as because you already did ACR2 in your first semester, I do not know how, but you know this one. But I, as I told you something, so I am assuming you have this one in your mind. Stop space dash space. Now this one, if I write this one in spelling, this is stop space dash space. This hash denotes space. Okay. Stop space. This is hyphen space. Now, in ACR2, whatever the catalog you did, you use this one in your manual cataloging also. As for example, you did like this way, that is, Dictionary of Library, we are a RY library and information science. Stop space dash space hard web aid dot stop space dash space new YORK New York colon New York colon then you see facet PUTL dot comma 2010 dot. Now this is what you did in your first semester and this is what you followed AACR2. Okay, you followed AC. Now any one of you, can you say me this one? What are these? This one, that is this thing, that is what, this one, then this one, then this one, then this one. What are these?
Sir, linker. Linker.
Linker for? Linker for? Now see, okay, rightly you stated that one, linker. Now see, if we write this one like this way, suppose we are writing this one in this way. Suppose we are writing this one this way. Okay, suppose we are writing this way. So first one is this, this is ACR2 and second one is rather the customized. This one is the customized one that we did right now, we did this one. Now ACR1, this punctuations were not there. Or these markers were not there. But in ACR2, they included this thing, and you see, now see the problem. As because you are one human being and you have the idea that this is the title and this is the edition, it is written there, and it is New York, that is the place name, it is the Facet Publishing because it is a publisher. It is 2020, this is a year. So as because you are one human element and your brain is active, you already have gone through Librarian Information Science, you know the cataloging, and that's why you can identify each and every element. But whenever it is being fed to the computer, now the computer gets confused. Confused means what? That is dictionary of Librarian Information Science, it's okay. It only reads the binary of this one, fine. After that, it is getting a dot. It thinks that one, okay. So this is the dot. I have to stop here as because this is the dot. So this thing is something different and this one is something different. So after dot, I have to use this one. Then after dot, I have to use this one. Then after dot, I have to print this one. After dot, I have to print this one. But if everything is dot, now, what will be this one? Now, as because you are giving this one as a period, stop, it will simply think that one, it is also something that it has to process something which is rather coming after this one. So you have to make this one unique, and that's why ACR here to introduce this feature for computer, that is whenever the computer sees, see this is something, whenever the computer sees this one, that is stop space dash, it understands that one, this one is something different from this one, and this one is something different from this one, and then it is getting colon, as because it is not getting stop space dash space here, the whole string it is actually thinking that one, okay, it is something within it, as because I am not getting stop space dash space, so these three things are mostly in the same place, but in between that I have to print this one. So this is why ACR2, this is the first time ACR2 started using something for computer, because in computer it is very much important to differentiate something from other, and these are known as flags. Flags. So this, whenever this flag is there, it thinks that one, I have to stop here because the first portion is already covered. Then it is processing the second one and stops here, another flag, that is the flag 2. This is also flag, and it sees this one, I have to stop, this is flag 2, I have to stop there. Then it is processing this one, but it is not getting anything in between this, so it is considering this one as a whole string, and then this one up to this, and then it is thinking that one, this is FLAG flag 3. So first in ACR2, we started seeing that one, ACR2 started converting that one, their classification code or catalog code for implementing that one in accordance to that is the ACR2 rule. Now regarding this one, you have to understand or you have to see this thing, that is what, if you go to this particular organization, is rather the most important organization. Oh God. This particular organization is the main organization in the world, Library of Congress. And this organization, they talked about all these things. That is why right now the cataloging should be converted or cataloging should be done by using the machine, because people are rather very much in favor of digital environment rather than that of the manual environment. So that's for why they started doing that one, library catalog. So this is the catalog, they are checking this one, and then they made this one, that is the OCLC, that is the library catalog, and here you can browse the catalogs on the basis of this one. So title, you see, now what are the things? The different titles. Right now, the cataloging can be done with this one. So suppose the subject, and in your subject, you are writing catalog. Write catalog, because this is the American, they do not use catalog, G-U-E, that is the British spelling. Now search it, Once you will search, you will see this one catalog, 131 records are there, and then catalog entries. So you see all these catalog cards, and here you see this one catalog card. So you are getting all these things here. So this is what the record, full record. Now see, the records are rather coming in such a way, everything is given there, but not in Asiatu style. So this is what publication history, description, frequency, classification. This is the library of classification. Then the subject heading that you do in tracing, other subjects, indices. And what I really want to show you, that is what, this is the important thing. And this is what is cataloging right now. That is what the invention or rather implementation of MARC. What is MARC?
Machine readable catalog.
As you see here, this machine readable catalog, here these things are rather the tags. So if you want to see the MARC tags, just here you write MARC 21 tags list. Just you see this one. See this thing, that is MARC tags. And here you see these are the tags. So whenever you are saying author, MARC tag is 100. This is what the MARC tag is 100. So now whenever you are writing 100, the computer will understand that one. This is, you are saying that one, author. Now, first indicator, that is 0 means phone name, 1 means surname, 3 means family name. Now, how you have to write this one? So these are the subject fields. And each and every subfields are to be written like this way. I will tell you that one later, but right now it is not important. So this is MARC tag. Okay. So now I'm showing you another such thing, like say PC card catalog. There is one particular company named as libraryconcepts.com. They developed one software for generation of catalog cards. This is known as Concept 3. Previously, it was known as PC card catalog. See this one, the PC card catalog. So here is a demo. You can download this one also, the demo version. So name, write this one, school, required, write just web. I'm not a robot, download demo. And this is the demo. And if you run this one, you will see what you will get. This one, right? Run this one as okay, finish it, and you get that one. This is the head demo PC card catalog. So this is the demo version. You can use this one for 30 days. So this is the PC card catalog. Okay, save it. Okay, this is the PC card catalog. Just to go for continue using sample data. Continue, just go for the continue, and here you see. So these are the different titles. So they already given this one. See, this is what is the titles and quit. Now you can use this one, so you can browse the catalog like this way, and here you see the line, level line, call number, call letters, everything is there. So only thing is that media type you can write. But if you want to print this one, see, print catalog cards. So card font, just take this one and okay, then open this one. Subject catalog, this thing. And then levels, print card catalogs. Catalog cards, print cards, no list. Okay, card font, printer alignment. Let me see this one. No. Okay, in AVGD. And from this place, I can show you that one in POHA also. Okay, includes in there. So this is what one place where you can write everything, barcode 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Suppose this is what the entry you can write. Media type, this is a book, and then include summary. So these are the different catalog components. This is a physical description, you see, profile location, all these things are here. At the same time, you can go for check-in and check-out. That's a kind of library management software. You can see this one, and you can see the list. What are the total list? Start this one. List on screen. So this is what? The screen. And you can select this one, that is the print. And here you see list order. Accession, barcode, title, holding. You can see that one. This is the subject. This is the shelf is not there. Author, list on screen, this thing. So next page. So this one. And you can print levels from this place. It is not coming. Let me see this one. Update keywords. Start. Before update keywords, mask the computer. Oh, another instance. It's not there. Wait. Update level. Item entry. Okay. Go for a new item. So suppose this is the accession number and barcode 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Media type. Accept as is. Suppose this is the book. And then author. Punjab Sarkar, title, cataloging, theory and practice, publisher, facet, publication location, New York, IORK, New York, ISBN. Okay, on okay. Now source, that is Globe Library profile code, series title not there, physical description 10377P, remarks not, subject, catalog. Okay, subject, yes, the cataloging, we got that one, subject place, and save it. Okay, so now go to the previous one and then save and print. Unable to save item, following errors. Okay. That is, it's not going to print. So now next. Okay, next barcode. Just print it, media type. Barcode is too short. B. Now another author, right. I-10. Cataloging. History and practice, publisher, WordPress, location, cost, 375, source, globe, physical description, 9318p, remarks, nil, copyright, and data, 2018, subject, cataloging, enter, cataloging, subject, cataloging, yes, now enter it. Now here you see, just click card preview. See this one. The card is already printed here, and you can take the print of that card also. And here you see the tracing, the cataloging, first one is author, second one is title, and this one. So there are software right now available, and that's why people are saying that one, what is the utility of using ACR2 and all other things? Because the softwares are available which can generate catalog cards like this way. So you can even go for save and print. So duplicate barcode number, okay, change it to 7 and save and print. Okay, so following error, the title field cannot be blank. Oh God. Oh, I think this is the first one, the second one. So you got this one. So this is how right now the cataloging is being done with the help of MARC records, where this software, PC card catalog, or rather Koha or Soul or any library management software, now includes MARC 21 tags. And you know that one, if you do this one, if you know the MARC tags, you can catalog that one of your own. And if you save that one in MARC format, that can be uploaded, that can be imported by any cataloging agency. And that is where, that is the recent trend is. So this is the beginning of the trend, where a standard is already changed from manual standard. We are rather gradually going towards the computer standard, digital standard, and where MARC 21 is the pathway of new trends in cataloging. So now, after today, the next day, I will tell you something regarding MARC 21, then FRBR, then RDA, and then we can go for keyword extraction. So these are rather the trends now. Got the point? So with these, I'm stopping here. Thank you very much for your attention.